Hello and welcome students. Today in this video we shall learn about the beautiful story Birth, that is an excerpt of the book The Citadel, which is written by A.J. Cronin. The story is titled Birth because the complete story revolves around the birth of a child. The objective of the story is to teach the students that the doctors, they work like an angel. We must respect the doctors. The story opens at the house of a doctor. Name of the doctor is Dr. Andrew Manson. There is a person whose name is Joe Morgan. Mr. Joe Morgan was a driller in a mine. He was a very healthy person, and this night he was waiting for the Dr. Andrew Manson at his house. When doctor came to the house, he found Joe Morgan waiting for him. When he asked why he was waiting for him, at that time Mr. Morgan told him that his wife was expecting her first baby, and the marriage of Mr. Morgan took place 20 years before. It means to say it was very crucial moment for Mr. and Mrs. Joe Morgan that they were expecting their first baby after their marriage after 20 years. Andrew Manson, who was just returned after having a fresh quarrel with his beloved, he was in a thought of distress. But instantly doctor said, I just come to you after having my bag. Doctor came inside the house and returned back with his bag of medicines and the necessary equipments. Both Mr. Morgan and Mr. Andrew Manson, the doctor, they reached at the house of Joe Morgan. Upstairs, which was a small house, there were three ladies in the house. Those were the three ladies, the wife of Joe Morgan, there was midwife or the nurse, and the mother of Mrs. Morgan's or mother-in-law of Joe Morgan. Doctor investigated the lady and he found that it will take the time to get the baby born. That's why he went to the kitchen downstairs, and the mother of Mrs. Morgan offered the doctor a cup of a tea. It was a cold night, the wind was blowing, which was very much chilled, and the doctor, Mr. Andrew Manson, did not expect such a night for his life that he was facing the quarrel with his beloved, and now he had an important case to attend. But he was fully attentive regarding the case. After investigation, he sat in the kitchen. Lady Mrs. Morgan's mother was very much wise and attentive and careful. She was believing that the doctor may not leave the house. That's why she offered him the tea. And Mr. Andrew Manson, the doctor, assured the lady that I shall not leave the case in between and shall remain with you until the child is born. So it was the greatness of the doctor. Now the 1 hour elapsed, passed, another hour elapsed. Doctor sat near the fire and he lost in the thoughts of the quarrel with his beloved. Andrew Manson was thinking about the quarrel with his beloved, and he thought about some of the failure cases of the marriage. At first he thought about Mr. Bramwell, who loved his wife very much, but she deceived him distressfully. Then he thought about Dr. Edward Page, with whom he was working as an apprentice. His shrewd wife, she also left Dr. Edward Page. Now he was justified that women, they are very much disloyal. But these were the thoughts that were emerging in the mind of Andrew Manson at that time. It was 3:30 AM in the morning, and he went upstairs at the call of the midwife, and he investigated that it is the right time to start the work. He started to work with the lady, and it took near about an hour, and the birth of the child took place at 4:30 AM in the morning, when there was the sign of the first streak of the sun. The darkness was going and the light was appearing at the far horizon. At that time the child was born, but it was very much unfortunate. When the child took birth, the child was lifeless. The mother's condition was also pathetic. She seemed to be lifeless also, and the sweat started to appear. The drops of sweat started to appear on the forehead of the doctor. Doctor was a young one. Instinctively, there was the dispute. There was the dilemma in the mind of the doctor. And Andrew Manson very much instinctively took the case of the mother at first. He left the child by giving it to the midwife, and he attended the mother at first. He smashed the glass bottle and took an injection, the medicine from the bottle, and gave it to the patient. After 15 minutes, when he found that the mother was safe now, he remembered about the child. The lady midwife, she put the child under the bed by wrapping it into a newspaper, because she thought the child was lifeless. The doctor now took the child into his hands, and he found that there was the whiteness on the body of the child. And whiteness means, the doctor estimated, it was the case of completely asphyxia. It means to say the child has the problem of breathing and lack of oxygen, and because of lack of oxygen, the body of the child is white and oxygen is not reaching into the body of the child. The doctor very frantically demanded for the cold and hot water into two utensils or two basins. He gestured to the midwife, and instantly the midwife brought two basins of one for cold water and second for the hot water, and the doctor started like a crazy person, like a frantic person. He instantly sprinkled the cold water on the body of the child. Then he dipped the child into the hot water. It was so hot that the hand skin could tolerate it. Time to time, at one time in cold water, then into the hot water, cold, hot, cold, hot, and the process continued up to the 15 minutes, but the child showed no sign of improvement. Now the doctor thought about the promise which he made to the mother of Mrs. Morgan, to Mr. Joe Morgan, that the child will be safe. The doctor started to feel that his energy was ebbing, and he started to feel the sense of defeat, but he could not leave the case in between. Now he decided to make the final try, and he asked for the towel, a rough towel, and he took the blanket and spread it on the ground, and he took the child. The child almost fell from the hands of doctor. At that time the midwife said that it is the newborn, doctor, please take care. But the doctor, Andrew Manson, did not heed to the call of the midwife. He put the child on the ground and started to rub the chest of the child. He was hopeful still, and he continued up to 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, he found that the child started to show the signs of improvement. A mucus came from the bubble of mucus came from the nostrils of child. Almost the child, which was completely white, now his skin started to turn into pink. It was a full formed child, and the efforts of the doctor made the child alive. And finally, after 15 minutes, the child gave a cry. Now the doctor took the sigh of relief. There was the triumphant smile on the face of the doctor. Now he looked at the face of the midwife and at the face of Mrs. Morgan's mother. Both the ladies seemed satisfied, but the mother still was lying because of the anesthesia, still unconscious. She was dreaming about the child, and very fortunately, the efforts of the doctor saved the life of the newborn child. Now it was the morning time when the doctor came down, and he came outside the house. He found that Mr. Morgan, Joe Morgan, was still waiting for the doctor, and the doctor informed him that the child and the mother both are safe. And now it was the time when the last shift of the laborers completed, and the laborers were going to their homes. They seemed very much tired, and so Dr. Andrew Manson was also looking very much tired. Before going to home, the Dr. Andrew Manson said one sentence. He said, "I have done something. Oh God, in real, I have done something." It means to say the doctor was very much satisfied by the fight he made with the mother, with the child, and he was able to save both the life, and the doctor was completely satisfied. So this was the story, birth. I do hope you shall like it. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.